Gotta get that gold. So today I want to be talking to you guys about my favorite five nude lipsticks. So I'm sure you guys are wondering, wow, is this the girl from the previous video? I know, like, get you a girl that can do both. This is me with my face beat. Clink, clink. Okay, some people might be wondering, what do we care? Like, why is this girl telling us her top five? We don't care. I know you don't care, but let me tell you something though. Like, a lot of women of color have issues picking a good nude lipstick, okay? Because like many of them in the market, they are either too ashy, too pinky, or too beigey. And a lot of people like love me on nude lipstick. I'm a lover of nude lipsticks, my go-to lipstick color. And most people are always asking me, oh, what lipstick are you wearing, what lipstick are you wearing, you know? And I just want to break it down. If you catch me outside with a nude lipstick, you probably have me wearing one of these five, so stay tuned. So the first one I want to talk about is the Zaron lip stain, a matte lip stain, liquid lipstick in Buttercup, okay? So I just started wearing this a few months ago and I absolutely love it. It's like a nude brownish shade, okay? It has some kind of orangish undertones too and brownish. So it's really cool, kind of like a, you know, natural color. So I'm going to test it on here, so just watch. So my lips are bare now. I'm going to try on the Zaron lipstick. So something I learned from one of my makeup master classes I attended, you could use a dark concealer, like your contour color concealer, to actually line out your lips for a more natural look when you're using nude lipstick. So I'm going to use this MAC concealer and correct palette, the darkest shade in it, as a lip liner. Okay, I'm going to use it to line my lips. Okay, I need a mirror for this. So I'm just gently using a concealer brush, an angled brush, to line my lips nicely, like so. I really love using this for this particular lipstick, this method of lining my lips. Okay. So this looks very natural. So afterwards, I will now use the matte, the Zaron in the middle. This is how it applies. Okay, just start with a little, goes a long way. Sometimes I could use my hand to blend, or I take a fluffy brush like this to blend the lipstick, to give this ombre effect. There you have it. So the next one I'm going to be talking about is the MAC matte lipstick in Velvet Teddy. Okay, this is one absolutely lovely lipstick for women of color. It's very brownish too and has this pinkish look. So you can get your pink nude, but without it being too pearly or too ashy. So let's go ahead and apply it. Most times I like to use a lip brush to apply my lipsticks. And also, one thing I want to point out is, when we women of color are using nude lipsticks, you should always have a lip liner in between, okay? Because our skin shade is not as light as these lipsticks, okay? So when you use a skin color liner, and you apply the lipstick in the middle, the transition is not so like boom in your face, like a glazed donut kind of look. So I'm going to, I usually just, I don't know, I don't really do much for lip liners. I use my normal eyebrow pencil because they are brown. So this is my MacBook pencil, okay? So I'm going to apply that first to shape up my lips. Next thing I'm going to do is to blend the liner, just so you don't see that line then lipstick, you know. So I just blend it out inwards into the lip, like so. Then I can use my lipstick. This is it. Okay, so I dip my lip brush into it. This is actually a concealer brush, but any detailer brush can do. Okay, so apply it in the middle, like so. As you can see, I love to wear this to work, like it's such a beautiful color, and I also like to wear it when I'm wearing cool shades on my face, like blue eyeshadow, purple eyeshadow, because it really has that pink sheen I like. Okay, there you have it, nicely blended nude lip. So another thing I love to try when I apply lipstick is to clean out the ends, the edges of the lip, so that it looks very neat. So I like to use this my cream concealer from MAC and an angled brush, and I just take it to the side of the lip this way. Okay, it's better not to go too light so it doesn't get too hard to blend. So it looks more natural. Nobody needs to be seeing a white line around your mouth so you know that you concealed your lipstick. Please. And there it is. All done, all set. So the next lipstick I'm gonna be trying, it's another lip, a liquid lipstick this time around, and it's the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in London. Okay, like I love this lip line so much because they are matte lipsticks, but they are not too dry, you know, ashy. It's like a cream, but it looks matte, but it feels so light on the lips, and it doesn't dry you out. You don't have those cracking, you know, effects. So this is how it wears. Okay, you see it's so identical to the Zara one I swatched earlier. Yeah, but this one is like softer, and you like, it's one of those lipsticks you wear and people don't even know you're wearing lipstick. It's just the perfect camouflage. Okay, I always have it in my makeup box anytime if I want to add lipstick and just look natural. So I'm going to wear it now. I already lined my lips and blended it. So same way, I apply it in the middle of my lips. Can you see? Can you see that? Can you see how beautiful it is? Like, it's beautiful. So you guys, you can see how the color looks on me. That's the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream. It's very brownish and woman of color friendly. I absolutely love it. I'm gonna spray some to freshen up the face. Okay, so the next lipstick I want to talk about is the Colored Rain. This is my favorite lipstick of all time. Colored Rain liquid lipstick in marshmallow. Okay, I have it swatched somewhere here. I don't know if you can just swatch for me. It has this color like pinkish, purplish, grayish, you know. It has all the colors together. It's so beautiful. Oh my god, like I love to wear it all the time. You can see that it's almost empty. Like, I'm barely going to get anything out of this tube. But I'm going to try. It's worth a try, you know. I use it on myself, on my clients. It's just a game changer, you. Like, there's no day I wear this lip that people will be like, what are you wearing? It's just so nice. So this is it. You don't have to wear lip liner with it, or you can wear, I like to wear brown lip liner when I'm using it, but today I'm not wearing any lip liner at all, because it just suits me, it just sinks in, and it's kind of like a statement, because it's kind of gray, so you just want it to pop out, but it doesn't look ashy at the same time, if you know what I mean. I don't even need to conceal my lips when I use this, because the control is there. It's just a perfect design. I love it so, so much. So this is it on me. Okay. Color Green Marshmallow. My best new lipstick of all time. Okay. The last one coming through. So the next lipstick I'm swatching or I'm reviewing is the Beauty by AD in Candid. This is a Nigerian made lipstick, and oh my god, I can't believe it's a Nigerian lipstick. It's so good. It's literally a tube for this color green lipstick. Like, both of them are very alike. It's just that I think this is a bit cooler. So as usual, I've lined my lips with my brown lip liner, and I'm going to go in with this. Okay, so here. Feels very creamy and rich once you apply it. And a little goes a long way, okay? When applying new lipsticks, you don't want to go all in, okay? It's not like a red lipstick or a pink. You need to like put a little bit, blend it, see how it looks, then add more at will. In fact, you do it with all your lipsticks, but nude in particular, so you don't end up looking like a place donut, okay? There it is. This is the Beauty by Art in Candid. Another thing I love to add to my nude lipstick, as you all saw at the beginning of the video, is lip gloss. I love lip gloss, okay? I either use a clear gloss or something more juicy, you know, gloss bomb, Fenty Beauty kind of, you know, vibe. So I'm going to use this on top of the Candid. This is Jules from Queenslight Beauty. So I'm adding that on top to just make it a bit more juicy. Lip gloss is at any man. You guys need to get lip gloss on top. Okay guys, that is it for my top 5 favorite nude lipsticks. I hope you guys learned a thing or two about application of nude lipsticks, especially for women of color, and I'm able to guide you on some nude lipsticks you can get if you're having a problem choosing some. Okay, there's something for every skin tone, every skin type. So I hope you guys like this video and you subscribe to my channel, please, you know, support your sister. And thank you for watching. Follow me on all my social media at _honeyrichie_. Goodbye. Thanks for watching.